Hello, welcome to next session. In this session we will solve JEE main previous year questions of physics. Our first topic is physics and measurement. And the question number 1 from the year 2020 JEE is, a student measuring the diameter of a pencil of circular cross section with the help of a vernier scale records the following 4 readings: 5.50 mm, 5.55 mm, 5.45 mm, 5.65 mm. The average of these readings is 5.5375 mm, and the standard deviation of the data is 0.07395 mm. The average diameter of the pencil should therefore be recorded as option 1, 5.5375 plus minus 0.0739 mm, 2, 5.538 plus minus 0.074 mm, 3, 5.54 plus minus 0.07 mm, 4, 5.5375 plus minus 0.0740 mm. Okay. So as the diameter is measured up to two decimal places, that is 5.50, 5.45, 5.45, 5.56, 5.65, so the average diameter should be expressed up to two decimal places. Okay. So it should be 5.5, as average of these is 5.5375, so it should be 5.53, and next digit is your 7, and so to stretch it into two decimal places it should be 5.54. okay, so you have to take these two up to two decimal places, 7, make it 4, and here the next digit is 3. Okay, so the answer should be 5.54 plus minus 0.07 mm. Answer is your 3. Okay, so option 3. Question number 2. A screw gauge has 50 revision on its circular scale. The circular scale is 4 units ahead of pitch scale, marking prior to use. Upon one complete rotation of circular scale, a displacement of 0.5 mm is noticed on the pitch scale. The nature of zero error involved and the least count of screw gauge are respectively: option 1, negative 2 micrometer, option 2, positive 10 micrometer, 3, positive 1 micrometer, 0.1 micrometer, and option 4, positive 0.1 mm. Okay. Now, as a circular scale is 4 units ahead, so it is ahead of main scale, okay, or pitch scale. Okay. So when it is ahead of pitch scale, so the zero error is positive. Okay, when it is behind the pitch scale, then the zero error is negative. Okay, and least count of the screw gauge is the minimum dimension it can measure. Okay, so as in one rotation of the circular scale, 0.5 mm of displacement is noticed. Okay, so in one rotation, this displacement is 0.5 mm. And in 50, in one rotation there are 50 division on the circular scale. Circular scale means in 50 division the displacement is 0.5 mm. Okay, and so in 50 division the displacement is 0.5 mm. So in one division the displacement will be 0.5 by 50. So that is 0.01 mm or 10 micrometers. So minimum dimension it can measure is your 10 micrometers. And so answer is 2, and so that is the least count. Okay, so answer is 2. Next, the density of a solid metal sphere is determined by measuring its mass and its diameter. The maximum error in density of sphere is x by 100%. If the relative error in measuring the mass and diameter is 6% and 1.5% respectively, the value of x is, so we know that density is your mass by volume, okay, and this is m, and volume is your 4 by 3, pi r cube, r is your diameter by 2. Okay, so this is the formula for density. So we can take log on both sides. Taking log both sides, this will be log rho, this will be log m, this will be minus 3 log d by 2, this will be minus log 4 by 3 pi. So these two can be separated also. So writing it minus 3 log 2. Okay, now we can differentiate it. So this will be d rho by rho, this will be dn by m, and this will be 3 dd by d, minus 3 dd by d. Okay, so its differentiation will be 0, its differentiation will be 0. Okay, now dm by dm, dm by m is your plus minus 6%, and dd by dd is your plus minus 1.5%, as dm is dm by m is positive here. Okay, and this is your negative. So taking making to make we have to make both positive to find out the maximum apparent density. So this will, this for this we will take plus 6%, and for this we will take minus 1.5%. Okay, so the we can, so we can measure maximum error in density. Okay, so it will be 6 plus 3 into 1.5, so that is 10.5. now d rho by rho is given as x by 100, so value of x will be 1050. Okay, next the quantities x 1 by mu naught epsilon naught root y e by b and z l by c are defined as, their defined their c capacitance, e electric field, r resistance, b magnetic field, l length, and epsilon naught and mu naught free space permittivity and permeability respectively. Options are, then options are, one, only x and y have same dimension. 2, x, y and z have same dimension. 3, only x and z have same dimension. 4, only y and z have same dimension. Okay, x and y, this x and this y, e by b, electric field by magnetic field, and this is 1 by root of space permeability and permittivity, represent velocity of light. Okay, so these are the velocities. Okay, now we have to so x and y have same dimension. Okay, now we have to determine z is your l by cr. Okay, so l is your length, and c is your capacitance, and r is your resistance. Okay, so the dimension formula of length is l. Okay, now c is capacitance. Now c is given by c, we know that c into v is your charge. Okay, where c is your capacitance and v is your voltage, and voltage is nothing but potential energy per unit charge. Okay, and q is charge. Okay, so dimension of voltage will be dimension of energy divided by q. Okay, so it will be dimension of energy is your ml square t minus 2 fourth into displacement. Okay, so mlt minus 2 is your fourth, l multiplied by l is your displacement. Okay, so this will, this is the dimension of v. okay, now putting the dimension of v here, voltage here, we can find out the dimension of c, so that is q square ml square t minus 2. Okay, now we have to determine the dimension of r also. So now we know that voltage is current into resistance. Okay, and and current is just charge by time, so q by time, so t is time, q is charge, so v is your ml same, that we have used up here. So ml square t minus 2 by q, so dimension of l r will be ml square t minus 1 by q. Okay, so z becomes l by cr. Dimension of l is l, dimension of c, this dimension of c is q square by ml square, q square by ml square by t minus 2, q square and the dimension of this is the dimension of r.